It reacts to sound. It reacts to light. And it reacts to gravity, presenting the illusion of a bucket half full of glowing liquid. It is GlowFlow interactive LED sculpture.
The GlowFlow project was my way of beta testing a pre-production Pixelblaze 3, putting a unit through its paces and report bugs as I find them. The adventure started here, with an LED strip still in a spool under control of the Pixelblaze as the brains of the operation. We see a stack of two circuit boards here. The one on top is the sensor board, an optional expansion for Pixelblaze. This particular one is an older version. Newer ones have an audio line and jack and a few other advancements. Below the sensor board is a freshly baked Pixelblaze 3 taking in power via USB and sending out LED control signals. The magic of Pixelblaze is on the software inside, simplifying the process of writing programs to control up to thousands of individually addressable LED modules. This video won't be covering the calculations or the software side of GlowFlow very much, because math and coding really doesn't work well in a YouTube video. Please see the video description for links to project write-up and GitHub repo with the code. These bright and colorful LEDs are actually only running at 5% power. This is enough for me to see their colors as I play with writing Pixelblaze patterns. I decided to make the LED strip into a cylinder, but I wanted the LED modules to line up vertically one loop to the next as they wound around the cylinder. This meant I need a very specific diameter for my cylinder, so I designed and printed a short piece to make sure the LEDs do indeed line up correctly. Once I was confident I had the right diameter, I printed a full-size cylinder. Because these LED modules could get warm, I printed the cylinder using PETG plastic that is more resistant to heat than PLA plastic. It took up almost the entire print volume of my 3D printer and took over 26 hours to print. This cylinder forms the core for my project. Once printed, there was another test fit to make sure LEDs do line up. Then it was time to peel off the protective paper from the double-sided tape and commit to installing the strip on the cylinder. I designed a channel on the outside of the cylinder for me to follow as I wind the LED. Following the channel ensures even spacing as the helix wound around the cylinder. Once assembled, I ran one of the pre-installed Pixelblaze patterns just to make sure all the LED modules are blinking and working correctly. But I wasn't content with just blinking. I wanted to create something that took advantage of Pixelblaze's ability to map individual LEDs to their location in three dimensions. To test this pixel mapper functionality, I created a test program that sweeps along each axis. When my array is mapped right, red will move in the positive X direction, green for positive Y, and blue for positive Z. After the three-dimensional axes were figured out, I started working on a Pixelblaze pattern that reacted to gravity using the accelerometer on the sensor board. This involved conversion to polar coordinate space and some coordinate transform matrix math. Details are in the write-up, but we can see the result here. GlowFlow is now a physically interactive piece. This was the state I brought to the Hackaday Los Angeles July meetup. For presenting my work in progress, I had some kitchen paper towels taped on top of my LEDs as a light diffuser. After the meetup, I started experimenting with different ways to 3D print translucent light diffusers, including a flat featureless surface, horizontal rib surface, and a diamond pattern of multiple thicknesses. I eventually decided to go with a flat surface so the LEDs get all the attention without any surface texture distraction. The diffuser panels and their support rib forms an external shell for GlowFlow. Inside the cylinder, my placeholder USB power bank was replaced with a more powerful system so I could drive the LEDs up to full power. These components mark the successful completion of GlowFlow. We'll end this video with a silly little GlowFlow trick. As I mentioned at the start, GlowFlow reacts to sound via a microphone. Here, I put GlowFlow on top of a subwoofer and turned up the volume. The thumping is picked up by the accelerometer for an extra dimension in its reaction.